first and 10, wants it all. Deep over the middle for Winicky, has it inside the 10.
Still with it, Diana Powerhouse!
Ilfil Velez on the run, diving in the alley.
It's Alexander with a nice move, goes to the rim, got it to go!
Hi, friends, and welcome to the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam. Delighted you could join us this week. Straight ahead, highlights of the SDSU women's basketball team's lone game of the weekend and a very disappointing last-second loss at Omaha. The Jackrabbit men played two games on the road, losing at Denver before winning in a gritty effort on the road at Omaha. We'll have all the highlights and comments from head coaches T.J. Otzelberger of the men and women's coach Aaron Johnston. But we begin with a senior student-athlete spot Spotlight on a graduate transfer from Southern Utah who grew up in the Phoenix, Arizona area. Here's more on AJ Hess.
My first encounter with basketball was when I was, I believe, 6 years old. I originally played baseball or t-ball at that time. And my mom said, hey, just try basketball out for a season. If you don't like it, you never have to play it again.
But Hess did like it. In fact, he loved the feeling of watching the ball ripple the inside of the net. So he pursued basketball, but it wasn't until after his senior year of high school that the dream of a Division I career became a possibility.
So by the end of my senior year, I was committed to a D3 school, and then, as fate would have it, my AAU coach, he presented me with an opportunity to play for a higher profile AAU team called the Compton Magic, and that just gave me a ton of opportunities. I got to play in the highest brackets against great competition, and that kind of that gave me a lot more looks, and that's how I ended up getting, I think I got 5 or 6 D1 offers and a lot of interest if I wanted to go JUCO or prep school, so.
Hess would attend Southern Utah University in Cedar City, a former Summit League institution. Hess had a penchant for long buzzer beaters as a Thunderbird, but an injury early on in what was to be his senior season changed everything.
I got hit in the back of the leg, kind of like a knee to the calf type situation. Everybody kind of thought it was just like a deep bruise or whatever. And I kept playing on it, and it kind of, it never really got better. So I went to the doctor and he said, oh, I think I have an idea why it's not healing. And then he pulled up an x-ray and there's like a big crack in my bone.
Hess graduated from Southern Utah with a double major in finance and accounting. Because of the injury, he received a medical hardship. And since he had his undergraduate degree, he could transfer anywhere he wished to finish out his final year of eligibility. Enter South Dakota State.
He called me, I had a long conversation with him. I talked to TJ a ton over the recruiting process.
And what really kind of hit the chord with me is that he talked about his desire to play on a winning team, a team with some balance, a team that had a chance playing the NCAA tournament. Wanted to be somewhere where it was like a quote-unquote basketball school, where fans really supported it and people felt like they're playing for something bigger than themselves. And that kind of, when we started talking, that really stood out to me.
I love his personality, I love his positivity, I love his vision for the team. I came out here, got to meet all the guys. The guys are great, top to bottom. I love the winning culture here. That was also very attractive, and I kind of like the college town feel and how the whole community behind South Dakota State.
Hess is second on the team in scoring, averaging nearly 11 points per game. He's made a few buzzer beaters here as well, including a game tying 3 as the horn sounded to force overtime at Idaho.
He stepped up for us in some of those victories, and those 3-point shots, especially down the stretch in games, those can be daggers to your opponent, and he has the ability to knock those down for us.
Hess is pursuing his master's in sports administration. You can tell he is well-spoken, and he is wise beyond his years, according to his coach.
He's very analytical. He really watches a lot of film, studies stats, wants to know the why with everything we're doing offensively and defensively, because he wants to play at his best. And he's somebody that has a really high basketball IQ, and I think his best basketball days, even though he's a senior right now, we think they're ahead of him this year, and then as he moves forward, because he's someone that's always constantly learning, studying, trying to grow and get better, and he's hungry to continue to improve.
Well, I like to pursue basketball for as long as I can, wherever that ends up. Just kind of see where it takes me. You can only play for a finite amount of years. Why not do it while you can? But after that, probably something in business. I'm kind of doing the sports thing in case maybe I want to pursue maybe being an athletic director, or maybe work for a professional sports franchise in some capacity. So not totally sure on the whole career after basketball thing. I got a hazy idea, but.
AJ Hess, as many of you know, suffered an elbow injury on Wednesday late in the game at Denver. Therefore, he missed Saturday's contest against Omaha and will not play this week. It is a shame, too, because Hess was on pace to potentially break the single-season school record for three-pointers made. And obviously, we talked to both AJ Hess and TJ Otzelberger on Monday before the Jacks started on their week-long venture that saw Hess get hurt in game one of two. The Jackrabbit men are back in action with two games at home this week, but to recap their performance on the road, we have the highlights of those two games coming up after you go on a trip inside state.
There's something in Hobo Week for everybody. I competed in Cavorts, the talent show. It was just something we were going to do for fun, and we ended up winning, so that was really sweet. My name is Hope Yager, and I'm from Watertown, South Dakota. SDSU is cool because it's so community-based. Even though there's 12,000-plus students, I can always walk through the union and know someone. I think it's really cool, all the different types of friends you get to meet. We do homework together. We sing together a lot. We just do random things. We go to Qdoba. We go there probably 3 times a week. That's accurate. I go there a lot. On Halloween, we actually have this thing called Rocktoberfest. And it's where we all like dress up, and we had like a dance party and stuff, and it's just really fun. My major here is music education, and I specialize in vocal. I want to be maybe an elementary choir director. I like kids a lot, and high school students too, but kids are kind of more geared towards me, I think. I'm really involved with Oasis through the Wesleyan Church here. Also, I'm in concert choir, so that's pretty much like a sport, and that's where I met like most of my friends. I've met a lot of people that are kind of nervous to come to this university just because it's so big and like they don't know how they're gonna fit in, but I would really just give the advice to try everything and anything. Thanks to SDSU, I'm ready to make what I love doing into a career.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Welcome back to more of this week's Jackrabbit Insider. It's been a tumultuous season, to say the least, for the SDSU men's basketball team, and the Jacks wrapped up the first half of the Summit League slate at Denver on Wednesday before visiting Baxter Arena to take on Omaha on Saturday night. Let's go back and see how the Jacks fared in Denver and Omaha as we opened up the second half of Summit League play on Saturday night. First-year head coach Rodney Billups and the Pioneers were stroking it early, namely Jake Pemberton, who hit three threes in the first 2.5 minutes. And even though the Jacks shot 45% in the first half, including triples by Ian Tyson and AJ Hess, SDSU trailed 44-31 at halftime.
Down by 18 in the second, the Jacks put together a late surge. Here's Hess with the runner, and SDSU was within 12 with 14 minutes to play. Mike Dom from deep with 8 remaining, and the Pioneer lead is down to 10. Later, it's Dom again from long range. He finished with 29 points, 22 of which came in the second half. And then it's Hess with his fourth three. He tallied 19 points, and SDSU cuts it to 6 with just over a minute on the clock. But the Jacks could not draw any closer. Final, Denver 91, SDSU 82. Saturday, the Jacks ventured into Baxter Arena in Omaha to take on the Mavericks without A.J. Hess, who suffered an arm injury late on Wednesday. Chris Howell was huge early. He scored 8 of the Jacks' first 10. Mavericks opened up a 17-10 lead on Tre'Deon Hollins' drive to the bucket 6 minutes in. But then SDSU would settle in, and in the span of 30 seconds, three-pointers by Lane Severin and Ian Tyson made it a 1-point game. Next, it's Mike Dom scoring inside, and the Jacks have their first lead. Dom scored 10 of SDSU's 13 points in a run, the only break a 3 by Andre Wallace. And then Reed Tellinghuesen adds to the Jackrabbit lead as SDSU outscored Omaha 31-10 during a 10-minute stretch of the first half. Dom's and one gave SDSU an 11-point margin of error. And then Severin hits again from three. The junior from Pierce scored a career-high 11 while adding 7 rebounds. Mitch Hahn's three just before the break made it a single-digit game as SDSU leads 52-43 at half. Mavs start the second half strong. Marcus Tyus hits from three. Later, it's Zach Jackson with a three from the corner, and Omaha has rallied to tie it at 56. With SDSU in need of a spark, it is Severin who comes flying in for the putback dunk. And then Michael Orris. He only had 4 points, but these were 2 big ones. And Dom a minute later from outside. Jacks a 12-2 run capped by Tyson's second triple. And it's 68-58 SDSU with 8 minutes to play. Howell shows off his athleticism at the rack. He scored 16, a new career high for the Milwaukee product. Severin's three with 5:17 left made it a 10-point game again, but the hosts would chip away. Mitch Hahn scores. Then Tre'Deon Hollins the steal and score moments later. The Mavericks would hit 5 straight free throws and cut it to 2 with 2 to play. But here's Dom, 33 points for the sophomore on the 11 of 18 shooting. He also snagged a game-high 9 rebounds. Jacks by 2, 10 seconds remaining, and Howell is fouled. The JUCO transfer and sophomore calmly buries both tosses at the stripe. And SDSU comes away with a gritty 88-84 win. With everything that's happened this season, it was an emotional locker room with head coach T.J. Otzelberger after the victory.
Yelling. Man, some personal boys. I'll tell you, you guys screw up a lot today, man. This hasn't been easy on us. You guys fought. You competed. I don't care about the stat sheet. That was all guts.
Mm-hmm. Hell yeah, boys.
So proud of the effort you guys put forth, the competitive spirit, everything you guys did. I couldn't be happier. That was a team win from practice to guys on the scout team, the guys preparing us and everything we did. Man, that was a gutsy win. I'm so proud, man. I'm sorry I tried to cross the same thing, man.
Kick their tail on the boards too, fellas. Yeah.
That thing so bad for you guys because you guys deserved it. You play hard, you competed, you earned that win. I couldn't be happier for you. Let's get the heck out of here.
Hey, bring it up.
What a show of emotion by head coach T.J. Otzelberger and the SDSU men's basketball team. And we appreciate them allowing our Justin Hansen into the locker room after that big win on Saturday at Omaha. The Jackrabbit men hosting Western Illinois on Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. And then we'll play host to Oral Roberts in the second game of the Lamb Bonanza doubleheader. Tip off at 4:30 on Saturday afternoon. Tickets available at jackrabbittickets.com. The league-leading Jackrabbit women played one game this week. They were on the road at Omaha yesterday afternoon. The highlights and thoughts from head coach Aaron Johnston after this week's Jackrabbit legend.
One of the greatest scorers in women's basketball history had perhaps the greatest season the program's ever seen. Melissa Pater's 2002-03 ledger is this week's Jackrabbit legend presented by Legend Seeds. Pater was one of two seniors on a squad that was coming off a trip to the Final Four in 2002-03. The Jacks won their first 17 games en route to an NCC regular season title. The Jacks hosted and won the North Central Regional, then won three games in St. Joseph, Missouri to capture a national title. And they did it behind Pater, who scored a school record 681 points, averaging 19.5 per game. She led the nation in field goal percentage, converting 65% of her tries. She also averaged 8 rebounds per game and hit 78% at the free throw line. A school record season and a national championship for Melissa Pater's senior year, a Jackrabbit legend. This Jackrabbit legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties, and we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans, agronomy, answers, yield.
When you hear our school song, stand up, clap, and sing along. Show your appreciation for our team and our school band.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great. Before we get back to this week's show, here's a look at next week's Insider. Welcome back to the Insider. The South Dakota State women's basketball team is in first place in the Summit League, and the Jacks opened up the second half of the league slate on Saturday afternoon as they took on the Omaha Mavericks in Baxter Arena. The Jacks took an early lead with a 6-0 run after Omaha scored first. Ellie Thompson puts SDSU on the board. Moments later, a steal by Alexis Alexander, and Lexi goes all the way for two. This Kira Young bucket gives the Jacks a 6-2 lead. Now Omaha's standout Michaela Shaw scored 7 straight for the Mavs, including this three. And despite Alexander's buzzer-beating layup, it is 19-17 Mavericks after one. To the second, and Omaha settles in from deep. First, it's Marissa Preston, and then Amber Vidal. The Mavericks hit 16 of their 29 three-point attempts in the game. The Jacks go on an 8-0 run, capped by back-to-back Thompson buckets to cut the lead to 2. But Omaha responds in kind with an 8-0 run of its own. This Clarissa Ober basket brings the Jacks within 9 at halftime. It's Omaha 40, Jacks 31. In the third, it's Thompson trying to spark something. She finished with 23 points and 7 rebounds. Then Madison Giebert heats up, burying not one, but two triples.
Oberst 2, as the third quarter neared completion, cut an Omaha lead that once was 12 down to 6. Marissa Preston's three opens the fourth and puts the Mavericks up 9, but the Jacks would shut out the hosts over the next 5 minutes, embarking on a 13-0 run. Giebert from deep. Now it's a four-point game. Giebert tries to go inside a minute later, and although it's unsuccessful, there's Ober for the athletic rebound and putback, and the Jacks are down 2. Another second-chance score. As SDSU keeps the possession alive, Giebert the extra pass to Kerry Young, and the Mitchell Natives 3 puts the Jacks on top with 5:42 left. Now it's Giebert again from deep. She finished with 21 points, 14 of those coming in the second half. Omaha responds. First Remy Davenport, and then Abby Lujan hit from deep on back-to-back possessions as the Mavericks tie the game with 3 to play. SDSU regains the lead on this Ellie Thompson 2. And Young adds to the lead. Jacks 78-74 with 2 minutes left. Another Marissa Preston 3. She hit 5 in the game, and Omaha is within 1. Following a pair of Ober free throws, it's SDSU 81-78 with time winding down. Davenport scores quickly to make it a 1-point game, and Kerry Young is fouled with just seconds left. She makes the first free throw, but misses the second. And Preston banks in this buzzer-beating 3 from the right wing, as Omaha stuns the Jacks, who had come back from 12 down to lead by 4 with 2 to play. Final is Omaha 83, SDSU 82. Thoughts from head coach Aaron Johnston.
It stinks. I don't mean this to be sour, but it is fitting that we give up a 3 at the end on a transition play. We missed a free throw to go up 3, so we just didn't quite get matched up there and had some confusion. Those are things that we can work on as a staff and try and do a better job of getting everybody more comfortable. But, you know, ultimately they played very well today, and had they lost, that would have been a very disappointing loss for them because they were better than us for the majority of the game. We were fortunate to get kind of back in it and have a chance to win it, so it's very heartbreaking to lose it like we did at the end. But to be honest with you, for the majority of the game, they were a better team today.
Despite the loss, Jackrabbit women still tied for first in the Summit League standings, and they host both of their rivals this week at Frost. On Thursday, the North Dakota State Bison come to Brookings. Tip is at 7 o'clock, and then on Saturday at 2 o'clock, Game 1 of the Lamb Bonanza doubleheader and the South Dakota Showdown Series presented by South Dakota Corn as SDSU takes on USD.
To me, sustainability means being able to feed the world in the future.
We need to produce more with less.
It's knowing that our soil is going to be in better shape this year than it was the year before.
We need to stop erosion at the top of the hill, not at the bottom.
We find that we can merge sustainable practices with profitability.
It's about caring for the land.
It's about passing it on to the next generation.
It's about doing the right thing. I have a responsibility.
For the people of South Dakota.
To feed the world.
The future of farming is very bright.
I'm Jeff Lochner.
Steve Halverson.
Al Muron.
This is farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
Welcome back inside our Yeager Media Center studios and more of the Jackrabbit Insider. Well, if you like SDSU athletics and supporting the student athletes here in Brookings, you have a plethora of occasions to do just that this week. With men's basketball, women's basketball, and wrestling, there are six home events beginning on Wednesday. It starts on Wednesday night. The Jackrabbit men's basketball team tips off the month of February, hosting Western Illinois. That game will start at 7 o'clock in Frost Arena. It's rivalry week for the women's basketball squad, as Aaron Johnston's team hosts both of them. Thursday, it's North Dakota State that will come to Brookings. The Jackson Bison will tip off at 7 o'clock. Friday, the SDSU wrestling team will hit the mat in Frost to take on the University of Oklahoma. Last year, SDSU lost a hard-fought duel in Norman and will look for revenge Friday night at 8 o'clock. Then Saturday, it is a triple header of action in Frost that you are not going to want to miss. It starts at 2 o'clock with the South Dakota Showdown Series presented by South Dakota Corn as the SDSU and USD women meet for the second time this season in a pivotal Summit League showdown. That is followed at 4:30 by the Jackrabbit men in the midst of this jumbled conference race, hosting the Oral Roberts Golden Eagles. And both of those games are a part of the annual Lamb Bonanza Twin Bill. And if that wasn't enough, how about a little wrestling to wrap up your Saturday, as Chris Bono's squad hosts Utah Valley at 7 o'clock in the third and final event of this triple header. Now, this week is also part of the Summit League Food Fight, and fans are encouraged to bring non-perishable canned food items to any of the aforementioned events this week. There will also be collection spots at Frost Arena, and you can also donate money, as every $5 equals 13 pounds of food. The South Dakota State University Student Athlete Advisory Council and the Brookings Food Pantry are teaming up for this event, and SDSU raised the most in the Summit League three straight years, including 39,000 pounds a year ago. So join us at Frost for six events over 4 days this week, capped by triple header Saturday. Purchase your tickets for these events and see special deals by visiting jackrabbittickets.com. So to review, you have two opportunities to see the SDSU men's basketball team at Frost Arena this week, coming off that big road win in Summit League play. Two opportunities this week to see the league-leading Jackrabbit women's basketball team, including the battle for first place on Saturday afternoon with in-state rival USD. And two chances to see Chris Bono's nationally ranked SDSU wrestling program. On top of everything else happening this week, Wednesday is also National Signing Day for the SDSU football program. And we'll have a recap of each and every signee with videos available at GoJacks.com throughout the day on Wednesday, and more coming up next week here on The Insider, plus highlights of all of those big events coming up. So we invite you to join us next time. For all of us here inside our Yeager Media Center studios, I'm Tyler Merriam. We'll see you then on the Jackrabbit Insider.